many times have you thought to yourself, I'm going to quit my job and I'm going to travel the world? Well, a middle-aged couple from the UK did just that.
Turkish traffic jam, Saturday morning market day.
So there you go, we're 1 kilometre from Iran.
That's just unbelievable.
We're Marianne and Chris. In 2018, we quit the 9-to-5 and bought Trudy, our camper van.
We are currently on an adventure to drive the circumference of the world.
And Chris and Marianne join us now from the UK. Middle age, wasn't my words. What made you decide, guys, to travel the world in a van? And how did you make it happen?
It's a little bit mad, isn't it? We've always loved travelling, and you know, we brought up with my dad worked for the airlines. We've always had good holidays, and we had a little bit of a big midlife crisis. I lost a couple of friends. Marianne ended up donating a kidney to her best friend, and we looked at each other. The kids had left home. The mortgage was paid off. And, you know, we looked at each other and said, you only get one life, so we need to do what we want. We never know what's around the corner. So I quit the job and got the house ready to rent. We rented out the house, bought the van, and we decided to try and attempt to visit every country in the world before we die with the backpack or in the van. And we set off in March 2018. And this adventure... We set off January 2020 to try and attempt to drive around the world.
Wow, what a fantastic attitude to have. And great on you. The videos are superb, by the way. But it was a huge impact, though, on your travel plans with the pandemic. Where did that come from?
Absolutely. When we left for this challenge of driving around the world, it was actually in January 2020. So I think there was one case in Wuhan. It was not a big thing. It wasn't a pandemic. So we took off with hopes and dreams in our van, Trudy, and we crossed Europe, no problems at all. We arrived in Turkey and we were planning 3 days in Istanbul and then 3 weeks driving across the Black Sea coast of Turkey up into Georgia. And I think on the third day of being in Istanbul, the borders closed around us. The whole of Turkey closed down, as did most of Europe. And at that point, we realised we were going to be spending some time in a car park in Old Town Istanbul.
Well, 18 months we were in Turkey for.
Yeah, wow. In total, we ended up spending 18 months in Turkey. I think briefly, Georgian border with Turkey opened up, so we managed to spend a little bit of time there. But generally, we spent the entire pandemic and the entire lockdowns in and around Turkey.
Oh, well, I spent 2 weeks there in Kusadasi as a kid. That was about it. That was enough for me. I'd imagine as well it wasn't all plain sailing, though, as well. You must have had some scary experiences there.
Actually, the most scary experience I think we had was when we went to Georgia. We were in a mountain village called Mestia, and we'd heard about this place called Ushgudi right up on near the Russian border. And everyone was like, yeah, you can do it in your van, you can do it in your van. And no word of a lie, the tarmac road turned to dirt, the dirt turned to gravel, and we were literally driving along a one-lane track with a drop on one side, a cliff on the other, for miles, and there was waterfalls coming over the road. And being the passenger, Marianne does all the driving, being the passenger out of control next to that drop, it was very frightening. But we did make it.
You did make it, yeah. Looking for us, and more important, looking for you, yeah. Now, usually the kids go over to Australia, get a van, they just start touring around. You have a son here in Sydney at the moment, but what does he think about his parents living the van life?
You know, it was actually our eldest son's idea for us to start. Chris is not at all trained in videography at all. So they were delighted and suggested we actually start videos.
Wow.
And that's impressive.
I think they're shocked that their parents are YouTubers and that anybody actually watches our videos. I don't think that's sunk in yet.
Yeah, I think their friends think we're cooler than our own kids.
Yes, true.
Everyone always loves everyone else's parents. Well, I love you guys too. And speaking of the YouTube channel, Tread the Globe has nearly 10 million views. What's it feel like? You're making such an impact on people across the world.
You know, I didn't. I when I started the channel, when the kids said, I learned off YouTube tutorials. I had no experience. I never picked up a camera. Armed with a GoPro, we started making the videos. But it's been absolutely wonderful. All during the pandemic, we've had so many messages of people that have said we're stuck in our flats, and your travels are keeping us going. And yeah, it's really touching to get messages of people that are terminally ill that have found so much happiness, because we tried to show the positive of the world, yeah, and go to the places off the beaten track. Yeah. And it's just so refreshing to know that we're making a difference to people's lives.
You must definitely.
And it is very much. It is very much about having fun. You know, we feel really lucky because we're not quite silver surfers, because I hit the once every 6 weeks. But we very much feel as though we've had life experience of, you know, redundancy and mortgage payment and children and marriage and all the reality of life. And we feel really blessed to have that experience. And, you know, as you said, when the pandemic started, it was a little scary for the world. So we feel really lucky that we had each other, our health. It was great.
Well, we feel very lucky that you're sharing those experiences with us. I know that the father of young children, I'm telling them to live their life, make the most of their life. It's great to see you guys doing that. Chris and Marianne, thanks so much for joining us this morning. All the best to your family.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having us, and have a fabulous day.
Bye. You too. Take care. Keep traveling. Good on you.